So I was gonna make a joke about, I was gonna say something like Mario Odyssey, no day one update. It's almost like Nintendo finished their game before they released it. I was gonna make a snarky ass joke like that, and then the game was like, there's an update available. There goes that. Arrows will guide your way. Nah, fuck that. Anyway, this is really exciting. This is Super Mario Odyssey. This is the long-awaited game that we've just learned about not too long ago. It's finally here. You know it well. Mario's mustache is detailed as hell. Holy shit. Can imagine the voice acting.
This is the end for you.
Somehow Bowser is Danny DeVito. So we're right in it. But no, we're really just starting. I mean, there's almost voice acting. A wandering hat spirit decides to save a young plumber's livelihood. Because when you're a plumber, how do you start, have a business without your uniform? What if Mario's dead and this is like some kind of purgatory? I think this is purgatory. Now, who are you? I want to see that mustache. Give me that mustache. Oh, look at this. It's like kind of a Hat in Time-ish where the character gets
I
like
really mean it.
invisible. Did you just say, I really mean it? Dithering, it's called. Dithering. I like that word. Say it with me. Dithering. So sorry for running away like that. You startled me, and I do startle easily. It's this voice. I saw what happened earlier. You've been through quite the ringer. You've landed in the Cap Kingdom. We've been under attack by the same monster. I like how Bowser's now an emoji that gave you such a trouncing. Oh, I can look around. Let me see that cloth. That looks like raw steak. It's like some Koopa flank. To make matters worse, the fiend had kidnapped my little sister. Oh shit, yeah, we can't have that. Turned into a crown. I'd hoped to give chase to that monster in a ship of my own. Unfortunately, all of our airships were wrecked in the attack. They all look like hats. I'm beginning to think that there's some kind of weird obsession here. Although, now that I think on it, I'm fairly certain there's a functioning ship in the next kingdom over. You know, in the early days, there was mercury in hats, so it would drive people crazy. I'm pretty sure there's mercury, like, throughout this whole kingdom. I could get us there if only I could reach the top of that top hat tower, which is being guarded by the monster's henchmen. You know, it seems we're after the same thing. Perhaps we should team up. Let's see if we can't help those, people. New Mario look confirmed. Not your style. How about this? A Mario in time. Trailer shot. Mario's a Mad Hatter now. So I already love Cappy very much because I remember one of the main problems I had with Mario 64 was that like weak ass little punch. What the fuck are even frogs? I don't think I would like this. Holy sh! Is Mario going through the frog's like cellular like fucking nervous system? It just pictures of frogs. All right, that's some like Majora's Mask type shit.
Ribbit.
Top quality voice acting by Charles. Hey, hello fellow frogs. I'm here to join the frog committee. What are we meeting about today? What things shall we discuss? Interesting music for a Mario game too. I mean, well, it's almost in line. Almost. You can't ground pound as a Ferg, unfortunately, but you can pound some other, like some Goombas and shit. You don't listen. I was gonna make a pounding that Odyssey joke. It's just not worth it. It's a good thing I didn't make that joke or even insinuate it. But this has been a great year for those three franchises. We got an amazing Zelda game. We got a very quality Metroid game, I think. A return to form in a lot of ways. And now we get rabbits? What? The boss warned me there'd be a fella with a mustache coming along. I guess we ought to introduce ourselves. We're the wedding planners for the happy couple. They call us the Blue Dolls. We've got that treasure we needed, so we ain't got no more business in these parts. Of course, roughing up Goody Two-Shoes meddlers was the contract, so I guess we still got a little work to do. It's more Scottish. I'm sorry, I try to conjure the Irish, and I just get Scottish instead. It's a mean Mario? What do you want me to do with- Oh, no shit. Oh, okay. I have to become electricity. It's a meme! Minutes in and the game hasn't even started yet. This is going to be a long game. A very long game. Do you think that feels good? It looks like he's enjoying himself, but it's like a pleasure slash pain thing. Wait until you see Mario in the bathing suit. Those things is going to be fucking pointy enough to break glass. Or I can just do that, too. What was that? Whoa, did you see that? It was a cat Mario. It's like a 2D cat Mario. I'm gonna need to review that footage. I don't like shaking the whole controller, so at some point, maybe not tonight, but maybe tomorrow, I'll try the game. Maybe it's, tomorrow I'll try the game with the Joy-Cons and let you know how it goes. I am now in control of a Chain Chomp. I have dominion over a Chain Chomp. What a cute puppy. Good doggy. Moon get! Yahoo! First moon. The thrill of getting the first moon. Of course, after moon number 377, I don't know if my excitement level will be quite the same, but I don't give a shit. I got my first moon. Someone in chat just called the moons curvy boys. So we had nut boys, now we've got curvy boys. Nothing's happening. That power moon must not have given the ship enough energy. Mother of God! I wonder if we can find more of these around here. Let's see, I think we can. I think there's something like, what, 80 per level or something like that? Whoa, coins. Coin stack, please. Y'all wouldn't happen to have any chain chomps lying around. I could use to get in there. Nope, okay. Holy shit. Well, you're mine now. I'm a fucking dinosaur! The Super Mario Brothers movie has finally been realized. Open the door, get on the floor, everybody do the dinosaur. Or is it everybody walk the dinosaur? Fuck, I always forget. Yeah. Oh, I bet you think you're special, but I'm a fucking dinosaur! This is why it's great to be a dinosaur. Nothing matters. You don't take shits, only give shits. Oh! What is this? Oh no. God damn it, can't fucking escape rabbits. remember those physics I was telling you about? You know, those physics? Ow. Well, they're here. The future really is now. I love how Cappy opens up the possibilities of the game. Boss fights, puzzles. It feels like Mario, but it's nice. It's a nice mechanic for the game. I didn't say I said possibilities. The possibilities of the game. I have my suspicions that this isn't the real Earth. Alright, the hat is pretty cool. It's not as cool as Mario's head as a spaceship. Cappy turns into Skippy. So how do you like me as a captain's hat? Pretty classy, wouldn't you say? We need Mario Historia to give us the timeline. Now then, where were we? That monster's name is Bowser. Well, we'll chase him down in no time in the Odyssey. Seeing as how we've got some time to kill, let's review some useful skills. Travel tip, ground pound. Yeah. Decimate your posterior. That's what I thought that said. I don't think it said that. What if it's true love? Did that say perusal and not pursual? I might have just misread that. Sorry, my dictionary classes in college didn't prepare me for such a word. It said perusal. Oh, like perusing a shop. My bad. Huzzah. I declare the maiden voyage of the Odyssey a complete success. But why is it so cold? I thought deserts were supposed to be hot. Well, desserts are cold. Sometimes. Huh? At the top of that tower is shining, but how could that be? Could it be a power moon? The vultures are ready to eat Mario alive. Use this closet to change anytime. Right, so I remember when the game was first revealed, this crazy cap shop was analyzed. Game Explained probably released 3 hours of footage analyzing this one place. And they determined that, yes, this is in fact a place that you buy new hats. So this is where you, you can buy a moon. Oh no. I can't afford it, but... here we have our first sightings of Mario's meme nipples. I couldn't believe, after the last trailer, how many people were... like, talking about Mario nipples. It was trending on fucking Twitter. Speaking of Mario's nipples, people still keep fucking tweeting that picture of Mario telling the child, "Don't forget to wash your foreskin!" It, like, once every couple days. Oh, is that a Durg? Hey, Durg. I can't turn into this particular Durg. But it seems nice. I don't feel like Breath of the Wild had as good of a reveal. Like, the trailer was cool with Link, riding away from... is that a Finnaboing? I think I found the Finnaboing. The trailer was cool, where Link rode away from the Guardian, and, that was intriguing, but... the first gameplay footage was, like, kind of weird, and it was like... wasn't it, like, at some conference, or rather, some award show, and it was just kind of, like, off-screen footage, like, blurry off-screen footage, and it looked kind of bland and lifeless and empty. I feel like Breath of the Wild kind of worried me for a little bit, but this game didn't really worry me at all. I was pretty confident that it was gonna be awesome from the first reveal. But they also waited to show it. They didn't show it before it was ready to go. I really want the cowboy hat, but I'll get the sombrero for now. You ready? Badass! What is the secret you're seeking? I know it, haha. I can't tell you, but I'll give you a clue. Where the birds gather. It's hiding somewhere, no peeking, go find it. I don't know why I can do that. I will bet you 13 quid that that burb has a moon.
50 quid!
Lock the door. Dress like us, party like us, that's what we say. Snappy hat check, snazzy poncho double check. You're ready to party, head inside. Oh shit. What is this? What's happening in here? Is this like an Eyes Wide Shut party? The password is Fidelio. Oh my god. You must first cross the shrine of the Suva monkey. I didn't realize sombreros and ponchos came with a guitar. Or la guitarra. They're just in there. It's just part of the outfit. You summon the- you summon the guitar. The pipe, though? You saw a pipe? How did I miss the pipe? There was a pipe you passed 4 times. Wow, good for me. I can't wait for chat to type blind. What does the pipe look like? What am I missing here? Is it a real- is it like a Mario pipe? Oh yeah, it is. I don't know. Yeah, I did miss it. I am blind. Wow. No, you're right. I totally. Good for me. This is a really cool use for HD Rumble, which I think, by the way, is a really overrated. I mean, who's overrating it, really? It just, at first, people were talking like, oh my god, you can feel the rumble at different levels. It's amazing. And honestly, I haven't really given too much of a shit about it. It's cool. It definitely is a little bit more immersive, but it's not like... I don't even know if it deserves the title HD. It's like going to a movie theater and them saying, we have HD color. Or like buying HD glasses so that when you look around outside, the colors are more vivid. But HD Rumble is just kind of, it's kind of okay. That was the best use of it I've seen yet on the Switch. I like that. I bet you like that music. I did too, but there's a cube over here. I need to discover the secrets of the cube. What an odd stone. Holy shit, is this bismuth? Is this motherfucking bismuth? Cube. It's like that movie Cube. Did you ever see that movie? Where the people are like they're trapped in a cube and they have to try to get out of it and they get murdered one by one by the cube. If you haven't seen it, it's utterly ridiculous and worth your time in the stupidest sense possible. It's just whatever you do, don't watch Hypercube or Cube Zero. It's not really... it's not a good trilogy. Just watch the first cube and you're good enough. These poor bullet bills. Remember in Mario Sunshine where you had to, lead the bullet bill? You know, those days are over. Even in Galaxy. Now you are the bullet bill. Sand geyser. While I'm doing some moon collecting, I want to tell you about... So I went to the city. Which I drove in. I drove into Manhattan. I had stuff to do today, so I had to go in a little late. And I don't recommend driving to Manhattan during rush hour, but I had no choice. Go to a first place that I was recommended. First place does not have the game. Alright. Try the second place. Second place does not have the game. Keep in mind, I couldn't call the places because they weren't taking calls. So I had to go and just find out if they had it. Now, these places aren't supposed to be selling a game a day early. So that's another reason they won't necessarily tell you over the phone. But a lot of places just disconnect the phone on days like this. So, I had a third place, a third lead, if you will, on where I could get Mario Odyssey. And again, there's a necessity, because I wanted to put in a lot of time with this game. If you're new to the stream, here's the broken record. I wanted to put in some good time with the game, because I'm gonna be at a convention this weekend. Anyway. So I go to the, there's another place, I'm not gonna say where it is, but it's deep in Manhattan, and it's rush hour, and it sucks. So, you can't find a spot. Parking in Manhattan sucks. So you can't find a spot. So what you have to do is either go to a parking garage and spend 25 bucks for a half hour of parking, or you can wait for the parking meter to expire. So there's a commercial parking only. How do I explain this? Commercial vehicles can park by paying a meter. Up until 6 p.m. in some spots. Sometimes 7 p.m. This is gonna be a little convoluted. So, I wait in my car for 20 minutes until it's 6, so that anyone can park there. So, the sign said that you could basically park after 6, but you'd still have to pay the meter. So I wait, okay. I go to a meter, I put a couple quarters in. It says meter doesn't not in use. I go to another meter. Meter not in use. I find meter cops. I say, listen, I can't pay. I'm parked. I'm gonna get a ticket. I can't pay. The meters won't let me. But the sign says I have to pay. The cops say, oh, we don't know what that is. Did you try the app? I'm like, what do you mean app? Apparently there's a fucking New York City parking meter app that you can download. I was like, can I just give you the money? So the cop was like, no, you can't just do that. I said, okay. Then they say, park across the street. So, okay, I go across the street. I go to park. The spot's gone. I have to wait. I find another spot. I get the spot. This time, I get out. I go to the parking meter across the street, because they said the parking meter across the street would work. I know this is a convoluted story, but just hear me out. It's almost done.
parking meter across the street does not work. I cannot pay to park my car. I download the app. It takes 10 minutes because it's I have a slow internet, like 4G connection that's almost 3G wherever I was at that moment. Still can't pay. The app will not let me pay. Meter not in effect. So the sign effectively says I need to pay to park, but none of the meters nor the app will let me pay. Cops in New York City will give you a ticket. They do not give a shit. They want to give you a ticket. I did not want to get a ticket, so I did my best to find the cop, and I couldn't. There, you know, cops were gone. So, I ended up parking a full city avenue away from the place, which turned into me running to the store. Do you have Mario Odyssey? Yeah, we have it. Great, can I get it? Okay, I get Mario Odyssey. I do not have any money in the meter, and I'm worried, like, okay, I'm gonna have to fight a ticket, basically. If I get a ticket, I'm gonna have to fight a ticket and prove that I can't pay this fucking ticket, because the spot does not have... It says I have to pay, but I can't pay. That turns into me running, getting the game, and then running back to my car, and I didn't get a ticket. Welcome to New York City. It was worth it, though. I want to mention that the traffic sucked, and getting stuck on New York City streets with asshole drivers for like an extra hour was not fun. But, the amount of fun I'm having now was worth it. And the night is young. I can stream this game for another couple hours before I get hungry or pass out from exhaustion. If I pee my pants, it's fine. No, Saturday I won't be streaming. Sunday I'm gonna try to stream. Oh shit. Bird! Ah! Bird! I did that on purpose. No shit, what are you? What? Oh, you I thought that was just a style thing, but you can actually see secrets. This is an independent life form. This is an intelligent, sentient life form that Mario is just taking over. This is like fucking Bran and Hodor. This is not fair. There needs to be some kind of rules against shit like this. Mario's like, kind of a bad guy. Could you imagine Nintendo shuts down my channel because I said that and only that? To get two other little pieces for this moon. Oh, I can't break this ice. Oh, I see something. There's a glowing thingy in the thingy. Wait, wasn't I just there a second ago and nothing happened?
Is the elevator? Is the shard really? What is this? Tell me what this is. Oh, that's where the shard's form.
Oh, there's an elevator there. How about that? Blind. Sometimes my attention is focused in the wrong spot! This is fine. You know, I just realized it probably would be a great idea to, find out where the platform is before I come back up here. Hang on a minute. Yep, mistakes were made. Alright. You can go up with the guy. Yeah, well, let me leave those guys alone. They're not too, you know. They're busy. Oh, hey, bird! No. Shit. Bird, come back! Bird! God damn it. Hey, give me a break. I thought it was a baby cactus. But no.
The physics just rolled me into the fucking...
God damn it. Oh, that was a necessary step to get into the upside down pyramid, the Illuminati pyramid. Very important things are happening in this pyramid.
Stop yourself, Mario! Watch yourself!
Oh, I see. That poor thing. Evidently, that wasn't a farther, that was a farther jump than I gave it credit for. No, god damn it. Alright, you need to get out of the way first. I'm actually dying on the inside. You can hear it. You can slowly hear the enthusiasm drain from my soul and my voice while I play. Whoa. No, 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 you don't- no, sheep, please. Wrong way. Oh, no! What have I done?! No! I'm so sorry! Thoughts on Amazon Key? Oh, you mean creepy? Creepy Amazon Key. For those that don't know, Amazon's rolling out this thing that allows you to, open your door for, people that have, like, an app on their phone. And, Amazon delivery drivers can go inside your house and drop off your package. So you install this thing, it's like an electronic lock, and you grant people access, and if someone, an Amazon carrier, wants to leave your package inside your house, they can get inside your house. I mean, one, let's hope that this is gonna be a problem for some people, I think, eventually, but I don't know how well Amazon does background checks, checks for their Dr. Steve Brule now. I don't know how well Amazon background checks their employees. But I would hope they do so extensively. Otherwise, you just have, like, kind of semi-random strangers, like, looking at your stuff in your house. I mean, it's as good of an idea as how much you trust people. I also don't see any other sheep. The idea of, oh, fuck. Too fast. The idea of letting, like, the video shows, letting your, like, cleaning people into your house. Like, so if you really trust the people that clean your house, I can see that being useful if you've got places to be and you need to let someone into your house. Or maybe you need to let family in your house. Maybe this will be a thing that happens in the future. Maybe everyone's gonna have some kind of electronic lock in the future. So maybe this is the first step towards something that we're gonna end up making very commonplace. And, damn it. And also, I think... you know, what if there's a power outage? What the fuck are you gonna do if you can't get into your house because there's a power outage? I guess maybe- well, you know what? Couple that- oh. Capture! Capture! Fuck! I did the leaf level on my, like, second try in Mario Sunshine. And yet, I can't do Bullet Bill Baby level. Maybe that fucking bird will show up again, and I can find bird. Bort. I wish for there to be Bort. Okay, yeah, here you go. Whoever thought the dinosaur was out of place. Here you go.
Hey, you rewind, Dad.
What is that voice? Is that Klingon? Is that- it's Klingon from Star Trek Discovery. Oh, dear, pop! Got a customer waiting. But from the looks of this mess, I'm not going anywhere anytime soon. Burr. Can you speak again, please?
Mr. Human Man? Person? Human? Generic?
Hey, you Rubitat!
Hey, you Rubitat!
This is a very surreal moment for me. I'll take that. I heard one of the developers of this game doesn't like cats. -4. I heard another developer said that Toad was the most boringest character in all of the Mario games. I'm making this up. Toad could never be the most boring character. The louder you scream, the less boring you are. Oh, the D-pad, okay. Cool. So you can change the filter. Of course you can change the filter. Whoa. Blade Runner 2049 filter. Take a shot. This is really kind of cool. It's either really cool or kind of cool. It can't be both, but it's really kind of cool. Game Boy filter. That's me. You're probably wondering how I got myself into this situation. Well, nice Dutch angle. We Battlefield Earth now. This is a very, very detailed social media destroying device that this game has in it. Expect lots of weird pictures with cacti and Mario nipples over the past couple weeks on social media. Perhaps even months. I've edged you long enough. Let's do this. Looking for the binding band, chumps? Too bad, the boss has it now. And you guys ain't invited to the wedding! They're the wedding planners. I don't know, maybe they're not as cool as Koopa Kids, but we've done Koopa Kids how many thousands of times? In recent memory? I'm a dumbass. Coins do not restore health. Remember, this is not Mario 64. Come on, give me that shit. Fucking up the battlefield! Stop it! Alright, great! That was fun. There was the slightest hint of danger, too. I mean, I took a damage. A full damage. This is almost as bad. I don't know why people were so surprised that Mario had the nipples. We've seen them before in the cartoons and stuff. Adios mio. Yeah, I know. The other thing is that, of course people wanted to see the chest hair, because, you know, he's a hairy Italian. That's not always true. That is not always true. I'm gonna do this one time, just so everyone can be happy, and we can move on. Next question. It's just a slight discoloration. Are you happy? We did it. Nip get. Actually, just for the sake of curiosity, this is a pretty big map here. How much moons? Six. Come on, Nintendo, you couldn't just add one more moon? Just one more. Why, Nintendo? Why? I do like that the map list here, you can see where you got them. I'm a big fan of that. It's like the little Korok locations. It's little check marks wherever you were, wherever you got a moon. This is a fantastically big game, and it's very good that collecting a moon doesn't knock you out of the level. That is a convention that needed to go, along with extra lives, which I'm happy do not exist in this game. Losing 10 coins is great. Because you know, it's not a lot, but you care about coins. You don't want to lose them. And lives were just getting kind of annoying. It's like just a time sink. Losing coins is a time sink too, because then you have to go get more coins. But it's a little bit more... It's a little bit less shitty. And I like that coins are useful in this game. I mean, in previous Mario games, there was a utility to collecting lives, and I liked it. In this game, you buy shit. And it also reminds me of how, no shit. But why? It reminds me of how useless rupees were in Zelda games for a long time. What is this growth on Mario's nose? This needs to be explored. It's cactus damage. This is me. You're probably... That was scary. I feel fucking really bad for Mario. Look, he's got like... Dude's freezing. Like, I'm sorry, dude. It should be that, like, when you don't have shoes on, it's even more slippery. Oh yeah, no, this is my fault. That's why- it's exactly why I apologize to Mario- Mario ahead of time. Mario! Mario! Goomber. These feet don't slip on the ice. Oh wait, you're telling me a Goomber is useful? No shit. Look at he go. He's trying his hardest. Finally, a Goomber is useful. Oh, I thought we were friends. I thought I could just jump in there. I thought I could jump in. Oh, nice. This bullet bill had some protection. I underestimated! Oh. got this. I got this. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, this is the beginning. Oh. Deepest underground. It's like the darkest dungeon. Seems to be a pedestal here for a Mario. Am I really gonna have to do this with one health? What have I done? What have I done? It's the fucking boss from Spelunky. Ah, more hand bosses, Nintendo? Are we still doing hands? Jeremy Nintendo, leader of Nintendo, has some kind of hand fetish. You must acquire the compass of Henry Hudson. And that was quick. That's pretty emblematic of how I play this game. At least you can get your coins back. Yeah. Oh. Oh shit. This is awesome. Fuck man, this cap mechanic is awesome. I gotta give credit where credit is due. Even with another hand battle, there's still something new to do. I fucking Jeremy Nintendo knows his shit. Was deliberate! So long, Andross! Oh, I see the three moon. I see the triple. The top of that dude's head was in the sand earlier. This game makes me kind of happy. That's a good sign. Yeah. Captain Toad? It's Hint Toad. Holy shit, new character! We got a brand new character in Mario lore.
Hey, Mario!
To help out Princess Peach, I'm doing a survey of Power Moon locations. Having trouble finding Power Moons? I can help you for 50 coins. Wanna buy a hint? No.
Ah!
Guess which one I'm tapping first.
Let's see, it's a Waluigi amiibo. Yeah, you got it, I'll send this Waluigi amiibo out to look for a Power Moon. It's gonna take about 5 minutes to look, so come back in a bit. If you run into trouble out there, you can tap an amiibo while pressing, the thing. Can't promise miracles, but you get a little bonus, guaranteed. This is kind of out of the blue, but got a present for you. For introducing me to such a great amiibo. You want to try it on?
Get ready for the best costume in the game.
Wow, that looks great on you. And hey, don't be a stranger.
Do I have any other reason? Do I have a reason to change out of this costume? Ever? And the answer is no. Uncle Amiibo, I got one more for you. I'm not gonna do too many tonight, because that's just gonna spoil the fun.
Oh, it's a villager amiibo.
Oh, villager doesn't have a costume. Okay. The suit makes you want to lurk in the shadows, waiting for a turn in the spotlight. Is that a hint? The cap with an upside-down L on it. It's barely used. Holy shit. Are they throwing shade at Waluigi, or are they saying that Waluigi will be around soon? Are we gonna get a major WoW game on the Switch? That's really all I want. I want, like, a really dark Waluigi game. I think they can experiment with Waluigi having, like, a T to M rated game. Where, like, he attempts murder on Wario. There's, like, a, you know? There's, like, some really heavy themes that can be explored, like addiction. All kinds of shit. Give him a gun. Give him a gun. Fuck it, give him a gun. Have the developers of Shadow the Hedgehog handle it. I can think of one thing that would make this Waluigi hat a little bit better. If, when you put it on, Mario goes,
"Wah!"
Oh, this is nice. Are those birds okay? What are you? I'm gonna come back to that in a second, but we need to get this moon. That was a cool looking lizard up there. I wanna check that out. I'm gonna be friends with a lizard. See if we can find some common topics of discussion. And comics. Toad! Captain Toad! I got buried down there, so I'm so lucky you came along. Oh, but I found a power moon under the sand. Thanks for the rescue. Fucking Toad? Not just any Toad, but Captain Toad. The air is so fresh here. I mean, you're pretty much suffocating just a second ago. Captain Toad, we need to talk. When do you have a sequel to your game coming out? Art. Art. Look, it's kind of crazy that I don't want to leave this world. I know there's, like, I'm pretty much, well, like, halfway through. Let's see. How many do I have? 36? A little over halfway through. And yet, I still don't want to leave this world because I'm having such a good time. But I definitely want to see what else this game has to offer, so that bird is gonna be elusive, then I'm not gonna worry about the fucking bird, and we're gonna go see another world. Woo-hoo! Juice. Motherfucking orange drink. I want some of that. It looks good. I don't know, part of me feels like I should have done the Water Kingdom next just for the sake of variety. Like, it would have been a complete change to the desert, but At least they're trying something different. Like, so the desert is also ice. Then you have, like, natural with mechanical. You have, weird. It's usually the same fucking worlds over and over and over again. There's the green grass world. There's the swamp. There's the fire world. There's the ice world. There's the water world. The woods. The spooky world. Okay, I hope there's a spooky world in here. He kidnapped Tiara. Oh no. He kidnapped Tiara. And now with his binding band, he's got a wedding ring. Is he going to steal the whole wedding? Seeing as how we've got some time to kill, let's review some useful skills. Homing cap throw. Right. Okay, I know how to do that. According to this guy, there's a giant greenhouse that filled with flowers. It's famous for its beautiful Sarai bouquet. I don't even know how to say that.